But
and
no,
they,
that's legit.
You know what? The fact that you said that you're attracted to that style of comedy is very inspiring because of the whole, and we're going to get into it, the cancel culture.
Oh, baby. Oh, my goodness, me. Are we going to get into it now, or should we
cancel
get into
culture?
It?
Culture?
Yeah, should we get into
KKK?
It now? Oh, my goodness. Did he say... Hey, I didn't... Hey, he said that.
Oh, no.
Hey, don't censor me. TWG's nice and humble still. Come on, man. Welcome, welcome. This is TWG, The Worst Generation. We're back again with another special episode this season. So many different types of creatives for TWG to bring on, you know, to exploit potentially, who knows. Whether they've started their own photography business, like the last episode, whether they're doing work in the stand-up comedy world, like the episode after this one, or like today's guest, who's put whole bodies of music out there with his circle, and he's actually doing a whole other business that I didn't even realize. My guy's a CBD connoisseur. He's helping the future stoners of the world, baby. Literally, yes, sir. That's the one. That's the one. Oh man, but yeah, literally, TWG loves to throw all that aside for a bit. You know, fuck the business for a bit, and just get to know the person behind the factory belt. You know, as we already know here, I'm blissfully oblivious. My use of correct terminology is a testament to that because it's never correct.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not the sharpest with the crumbs or the crux when it comes to any of my guests' professional world. But that's why we're here, to learn what the fuck is even required, you know? Do you need to sell your soul to some producer in LA? Or can you find an equivalent in Redfern? Can you find one as well? Can you build anything up from the ground with a strong enough group all working towards a cause despite copious amounts of weed consumed?
Weed.
With an OUID.
Yes, sir.
That one. And how many times can you tell someone to rerun their verse if it was whack? You know, I'm curious. That's my... Do you get me?
I am curious. Bro, I'll let you know. Many times.
But yeah, it's great when a musician puts out songs with real life fucking lyrics, baby. When man said... I can't find my peas. I really felt that shit. That's I was like, at the end of the month, I was like, where the fuck I can't find my peas?
I can't find my peas.
It's a pleasure to have him. It's Neel today. How are we, sir?
I am fucking brilliant. We're
there we go.
Cool.
Thank you. We did a quick one before this.
Yeah.
I didn't realize how because usually I have like a half an hour window because the guest usually doesn't smoke as well.
Yeah, yeah.
But this, we were just like bingo bongo and we're
bingo,
going.
Bingo bongo,
right.
I got the drongo.
That's like, where's the guy drongo with the congos, man? That guy on TikTok?
Bars,
yeah.
Bars,
that guy.
Oh, man. I'd like to see it. Oh, I'd like to see it.
Literally, there might be a freestyle outlet. No, there will be a freestyle outlet later today. Give me some goddamn money on Patreon, baby, and you might see the whole thing. That's how it works,
bro.
Man. Support your artist, bro. Deadass. I looked at some OnlyFans like creators because you just do. Hey, they're all creators.
Yeah.
You said artist. You call me an artist? They're artists too.
100%.
Exactly, right? So I'm charging $2.50 per month for the base level of Patreon. That's super crummy crumbs.
Have you thought about putting it on Patreon? Putting this on OnlyFans?
I could as well, you know. I could just double down on Patreon and OnlyFans. That's true. Bingo bongo. Someone did mention this as well, and then... Obviously, hey, I didn't say fuck you to you, but now it's doubled down now,
double
right?
Down.
This is a sign.
Down,
I'm going to do it.
Go.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to do that.
Yeah,
100%. Hey, then I have an excuse to be there as well.
Exactly,
pay the players, baby.
Yeah.
Pay the players.
Yeah.
Anyways, and then that was because I felt bad because, you know, Spotify's, you know, a little bit expensive, $3 a month. Then I saw the OnlyFans universe.
Yeah.
$25 a month, $30 a month. And I was like, either I've undervalued myself or I've overvalued. Of they just really evaluate themselves. Maybe I can't say that. Hey, fuck you, I will say that. Do you get me? As in like $30 a month for one person? That's crazy.
It's incredible. The fucking energy that it's required.
Yeah.
Like that's feminine energy, bro.
That is really. Yeah. I can't do that, you know? As in like if I went $25 a month for my base level Patreon, my boys would be like, who are you?
Like they're establishing their value.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, that's
like,
very...
They're saying that this is what it's not saying that this is what I'm worth in like money price.
No, exactly.
It's just saying like this is what I can do to you.
Yeah. Oh god, this guy's good with it. Yeah. Oh wow,
it's a test on both sides.
No, 100%. But that being
said, like chicks who don't have OnlyFans as well, there's nothing bad against them.
No, hey, we love them.
Guys who are OnlyFans,
hey, we love them all. I didn't say anything. Go bad. For it, bro. I didn't say anything. I actually fell on like not safe for work TikTok. I mean, not TikTok. Hey, crazy. Twitter. TikTok's
crazy, bro.
TikTok's
a rabbit. Hold
it literally, and it's too niche as well. It hits my spots, and I'm like, what's going on right
this
is now?
Like
yeah,
questioning. And it's like this bitch knows me too much.
Bro. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah, brings up like niche stuff that I thought I was past. You know, relationship stuff from back in the day. And I was like, I'm not gonna message her, but why would you do that to me? It's just really painful stuff. Anyways, not safe for work. Twitter. It's just porn everywhere.
Oh, bro.
I did not realize.
I do not have Twitter, so I would not.
Oh, you don't know? Oh, it's nasty. It's absolutely nasty. I remember, I used Twitter for porn, and I was like, what the fuck? This bitch watching GIFs, right? And I was like, that ain't much. I looked at it now, and I was like, my goodness, I should have been using this as well, you know? I was like, what the hell? This
could have solved my problems.
This is incredible. This could have solved
my problems.
But yeah, you know what? I should put myself on OnlyFans. It's a different thing, because I'm going, like, you know, $2.50 trying to... Just you know, a nice introduction into the market, but you put another spin onto it,
No spin. We don't put spin.
Hey, not today. Hey, exactly that. CBD connoisseur, baby.
When was the first time that you got caught?
Oh, dude, this is what fed into the ego as well.
I was gonna say with like by your mom. I want to hear the first time story, bro.
So
have you told TWG gang?
I don't think I have actually, not really. Okay, so okay, right.
Here we go.
So you're saying with the bud situation?
Yeah, with the bud situation.
Oh my goodness, I don't even know if she knew what bud was. I just think, like, I just remember.
What is this grass?
Yeah, she's like
bloody grass.
She was like, "What are you like?" Because she saw the contraption. She saw the weapon. Okay, and it was mine. Right now is quite small, to be honest.
Yeah.
But it was the regular size ones, you know. It looks either a flower vase or it's goddamn bong. Mm-hmm. You can't go wrong, right?
Yeah.
And she's like, what the hell is this? And like, the problem is, it's not like a rolling paper.
Mm.
A bong looks very violent, you know? It looks like, Jesus Christ, so much.
Why is this? So much just force.
Such a contraption in the cupboard of my son. Like, what is going on right now? Like,
put this up his ass.
Like, what is going on, man? It's so dirty, man. So many thoughts going through her head. And I'm just like, how am I? Oh, geez, I'm 24 now, fellas. Yeah, but literally... Would have been in high school, 18.
Okay.
And like, she's like, what the fuck? You're in high school right now. You're doing HSC and shit. And she saw that. But then honestly, nothing much. Mm. She was like, you can't do this anymore. I threw out the bong, but I got a new one in like 2 weeks or something. Because I was just smoking up. Like, I wasn't that much of a smoker internally. Like, as in like, loner stoner.
Yeah.
I wasn't that much. I was like kind of smoking with the boys.
Yeah.
But then like afterwards I got one for myself, and then like I just like started ripping with myself. I was like, oh shit, this is a different game, baby. Like this is a loner stoner is a way different game. You can start being creative like by yourself. You don't have to be like, done it for a bit. Do you get me? You ain't being judged. You're just by yourself. Yeah. You're chilling. Yeah.
Vibing.
Exactly. Yeah. Then I learned that situation. And then honestly, they saw a few times after that, like maybe like my dad, the first time he saw, this is ridiculous, honestly, because my mom saw the first time like before him, and I'm assuming she would have let him know. I'm assuming because my dad used to smoke darts back in the day.
Yeah.
So like she would have been like, "Your son, man, this is your son, not my son." Yeah, exactly. All that shit, right? So he maybe I'm just gonna say a year passed, right?
Yeah.
He's seen bud on my table because I remember I had to go downstairs, but I left the door open like a dumb cunt.
Yeah.
And then he's gone into my room. I just remember, I don't know why, but I just remember he's gone in.
Yeah.
And the first thing you see is the table. First thing he sees is the bud. And then we cross paths as we're downstairs and he doesn't do anything. Then I look upstairs, my bud's still there.
He didn't
do anything.
Happy days.
I was like, is he going to tell anyone? I was like, is he going to tell anyone?
Yeah.
I didn't get in trouble from mom either that day. Weeks passed, nothing happened. And I was like, because obviously in my head, I'm like, I'm fucked. And I was like, I'm waiting to get beaten the fuck up. Yeah. And I was like, this is fucked. But then this guy, I was like, after a week, I was like, did he forget? And I was like, am I okay? And then, honestly, my dad doesn't really care. Like, I haven't really had a proper conversation about it. Like, yeah, I would love to have conversations about Bud, because like sometimes they complain about their joints and all that. I'm like, and sometimes they complain about what they do with their time as well. Yeah. And yeah. I'm just like, and I'm just no, like, I... yeah. But it's a hard conversation, obviously, right? It is. Anyways, my dad doesn't care, but my mom is. Nah, yeah, that day was a weird one because she was angry initially, but nothing actually happened that deep. But in terms of the innocence, that went sort of thing. You know, that she was kind of like, do you have like a moment where you just realize like, oh, your mom just thinks you're own man now? That moment. Do you get me? Yeah. She was just like, okay, he's on his own now. Not on his own. That feels weird. Yeah. Because she'll always help.
Yeah.
But like, okay, he is just, you know.
He's becoming his own person.
And I can't say shit, you know. Because I think she would have clocked on to the fact that I had a second bomb. Like, you know, just realize. You know, I'm going to give him credit. They would have realized. And then nothing really happened.
Mm.
So it was just a weird... It's a weird relationship where we don't even talk about it too much, but it just kind of happens.
Yeah.
Do you get me? Is that... That probably is weird and I should address it soon, but let me...
Honestly, just talk about it more with them.
Yeah, I think that's the only thing. Yeah, that's literally the thing. Yeah. My main thing is I just want to fix myself up first and then I can talk about it. Do you get me?
Yeah.
But yeah, hey, whatever happens first. Hey, that's true. Being open with your parents is a game changer because I used to hide relationships with them from them as well. And I was like, man, this makes everything difficult.
Mm.
Yeah. But yeah, I think growing up, you just kind of just realize like these cunts are just trying to help, you know?
They're just trying
They're literally just trying to help. Yeah, yeah,
I'll tell you how, for me, when my mom first found out,
mm-hmm.
It was a tricky situation to navigate, but I audio recorded the entire thing because I was just like, in case she beats the fuck out of me.
Okay,
I need evidence.
I need something.
I need something. She's gonna beat my ass.
I think
I was like 19 years old.
Oh my goodness! Yeah, yeah,
she
yeah.
She found the bingo bango, bro.
Oh,
she found
everything.
The whole set. Yeah.
Okay.
She also found some mushrooms there as well.
So she was like, what the hell?
But she was just like, oh, what is a shiidake, bro? Like, she didn't understand.
Okay, yeah, yeah, yeah. Was like, well, you got mushrooms. Yeah.
But I had all the bud. I had the setup.
Everything.
And then I remember for like a couple of weeks, like she was really devastated because she didn't understand what it was.
So she'd just be like,
walk into my room, she's like, beta.
Yeah.
Breathe, I'm fine.
Exactly. Yeah. If anything, I might be better, but just exactly.
And then I introduced them to everything, and then they were just like, yeah, this is okay, we kind of understand this a little bit more now as well.
Yeah, definitely.
But it took some effort for sure, but at the end of the day, you can't change your parents, you know, like they've been ingrained with certain values,
exactly, in their head.
That's the whole, you know, the subcontinental.
Yeah, exactly. Bro. And give us 20 years, we'll have like ingrained things as well. Who knows? Yeah. So it's just like, I mean, maybe not, maybe, but like, it's just like these things happen as you grow.
Yeah.
And you can't just be sitting there, like, especially with like grandparents and stuff, trying to like argue with the grandparent, like, man, this guy's been up here for 65, 70 years, man. Like, let this guy just watch TV for a bit. Yeah. It's just like, oh, man. Sometimes people get like really upset at like, yeah, cancel culture. I know, especially with older comedians, they have like hard times sometimes. And I'm like, man, this guy's like 60 now, and he's just happy to be in the game. Why are you making it difficult? You know, it's just, I don't know. It's
they work silly. So hard. They work so hard for it as well.
Yeah, exactly. Like, all artists.
Like we go through like tough times.
100%. Yeah.
It all makes up. It's part of the painting, bro.
And it's all contextual as well. Like if you go back into the times, you'll realize, oh, it made more sense to say something like this or to do something like that at the time. It's just like. Yeah, it's very lazy when you try to cancel people. That's my only... It's like... Yeah, it's just very lazy. Because you won't actually...
How bored are you?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, definitely bored. Definitely bored. Yeah. But it's like... My thing is I love to make comedy where I try and think of the other person's shoe. At least... Shoes. Two of them. At least...
Just hopping around.
Right? Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's cancelling people is a very like selfish thing to do. Yeah, that's just my opinion on it.
Get done.
Yeah. How old are you, man? You're like
23. You're young, I just turned 23. Yeah, yeah.
Happy birthday.
Thank you very much, brother. Thank you.
Like recently or
last week?
Oh, happy birthday.
Yeah, thank you.
Damn, yeah, 23.
Another year, bro, but like so much time left. So much time left to
do stuff.
So much shit to do, bro.
Yeah, shit to do. Like, it doesn't even have to be like that professional, so just do shit. You know?
Did lockdown make you feel like that? Like where you were just like, oh fuck, like I really miss just doing shit?
Definitely, but like there were times in lockdown where I was like, sometimes I'd get lost in the sauce. You know, it's like, I just want to smoke my way through or some shit.
Yeah.
Maybe I have to edit this later. I don't want to get... Not straight away, but like literally, you just get lost in the sauce sometimes, like, because I'm just like, dude, 2 more months, smoke for a month. Do you get me? Like, it's a horrible, horrible way to use weed sometimes, just because, like, you're just like pushing through it and you're just like, you're not even taking a step back to realize what you could be doing with time sometimes. But definitely, there were periods where I was like, man, I miss stand up. Because, like, there were days where I'd have excuses now. I'd be like, oh, man, I don't feel funny today, baby. I'm not going to go out. Even though I could drive, I could do all these things just to go there. During lockdown, I was like, motherfucker. Even on my worst days, I'm just like, give me a fucking mic. Get me out there, you know? Just, like, get me doing some shit. Like, get me experimenting. Yeah, no, you're right. You're absolutely right. But, yeah. Because I talked about this with the last guest. I'll be uploading later. Yeah. But, literally, I got... There were times in lockdown where you kind of get stuck, for me, like, where I was like, I'm not sure what I'm doing. And, like, I mentioned this a little bit earlier, but, like, I don't want to fucking be like this, but hey, my plate felt kind of full, baby. I was like, man, I want to do this pod shit, wasn't doing it enough. I want to do this stand-up shit, wasn't doing that enough.
Yeah.
And then I'm also like, maybe I want to be a physiotherapist. And that's some crazy shit in the background, you know? Like, some random, some brown gene that I have. I'm like, I still want to kind of do that, you know? Yeah. As in, like, but I'm just like, what is going on? And I feel like, yeah, I mean, this guy, we'll talk about him very soon. Like, he's doing a lot of things. And he's already said he's used his 9-to-5 experience to benefit. And I'm like, Jesus Christ, how are you already doing these things very fast forwarded? But hey, we're going to learn, baby. We're going to learn today.
We're going to learn today together.
Yeah. Listen, bro. Yeah, exactly that. Fucking, I'm base level right now, baby. Yeah. I'm just getting up and, like, doing my reps sort of thing.
Yeah, 100%. You move.
Practice, baby.
Every single fucking day, bro. Yeah, every single day is just practice. You just need to know that you're... progressing with every single mistake that you make as well.
Yeah.
People don't understand how tough it is. It's because you're an artist at the end of the day, bro.
Yeah, that's true. It's weird to say that.
It's like poetry and humor.
No, you actually understand. Okay, yeah, go on. Yeah, it's really like the people don't understand how nerdy it is. But yeah, go on. Yeah, 100%.
There's so much fucking detail to it. I don't know if it's because I overanalyze anything when it comes to
art. But you're correct. So yeah, I mean you're correct. So yeah, literally, yeah.
Yeah, it just seems like certain people don't perceive that. I feel like it's more so, you know, you have to have a certain type of joke.
Like, they're two different styles.
Yeah.
I don't think people even understand that. Do you get me? They're just like, look, just make me laugh, motherfucker. Yeah. Like, do you get me? And I'm like, I don't mind that. Do you get me? I feel like that's the difference between the artist and the consumer, I guess. Like, they don't have to think that deeply, but it's also, that's why we love our diehards, because they will fucking analyze shit and they will actually understand like the layers to it. Because do you know Andrew Schultz? Have you heard of
Andrew
him?
Andrew Schultz, fuck, bro, every single morning when I wake up, YouTube, bro, this bloke's right there.
Yeah, he's right there. He's everywhere.
He's cracked the matrix, bro.
Yeah, 100%. He's killed it. He's the type of comedy that would be censored, right?
Yeah, 100%.
So he's a huge inspiration in that sense. But it's also like, he did a special. And do you remember those things on Netflix where he was doing those like it was like almost like that
the TV show style.
Yeah, it's like those news segment type of things. Yeah, yeah.
Quick,
like,
rapid.
And I was like, oh my god! Like, there are layers to this.
The photos.
Yeah. Presentation style.
Presentation. Oh my god.
Yeah, literally. I used to put like 2 out of 10 performances in in high school, like, presentations.
Yeah.
After seeing that, I'm like, man, I am keen for my next presentations coming. Yes. I'm gonna edit all the shit out of it and make, like, cause that was flawless. And then like, hearing about it on the podcast, right? He's like, dude, do people understand how much fucking work that took?
Yeah.
Like, we were rewriting jokes and shit and being fucking nerds about that. Like, and like, from the outside, I was like, these guys are the coolest motherfuckers ever. Do you get me? But they're literally admitting to themselves, like, dude, we were on fucking Adderall, on fucking Dexies and shit. Yeah. We were being fucking nerds studying comedy. And I was like, man. So, like, I guess that's the only thing that makes me feel like I'm doing something right. Do you get me? Do you get me? Just, like, it feels right. Thanks.
It's fucking respect, bro.
Yeah, I don't know. I'll definitely edit this later. Respect. That's 9 minutes in. You can't have that. Yeah. You can't have that. So, BestBudz, right? Mm-hmm. I've seen it on Instagram here and there, and I wasn't too sure if it was yours or not, or whatever the situation, but I was like, this looks really great. And I was like, I don't see much of this in Sydney, because I'm always like, because everyone hears about the dispensaries elsewhere and all this, like, you know, sounds really nice over there in a different country. But then I saw BestBudz and I was like, wait a second, in Australia? And I was like, wait a minute. And then, like, it's like easy to view product, like, posts and shit. And I was like, this looks really great. And I didn't realize Neil was completely related to this, but he apparently here. So let's get a word from him as well. Talk to us about this stuff, baby. What are you doing with this? How is it, you know?
Life is good, bro.
Life is great, baby.
Life is good.
Life is good.
I'm honestly so proud to now move into an industry where I feel like there's a genuine hope to help people.
Yeah, definitely. You
know, there's more of a push towards CBD because people don't realize that it's something that could be useful for almost everybody. I'm not saying for everyone.
Yeah, of course.
But we just wanted to open up a line of communication mm-hmm. between at least a doctor.
Yeah.
And mic check. Yes, sir. Boom, bap.
Yes, sir.
Bingo, bango.
Bingo, bango. Yeah, no, it's all good.
So I was just, what was I saying? What was the last thing that I said?
Opening up the windows for doctors, for everybody else to like connect the CBD situation.
Yeah, connect a line of communication between the person and the doctor is just going to allow, you know, people to understand whether this is right for them or not.
It could help you out. So it's almost like allowing it as a treatment, as a medication almost.
Exactly. There are so many people, we linked up with someone in the Epilepsy Foundation for Australia, mm-hmm. Danielle Buskilla.
Hey, shout outs.
Yeah, shout outs, bro. So she was incredible. She, you know, spoke to us about like how she was dealing with epilepsy very, very young age.
Okay.
And then, you know, we gave her the products from some of our companies and she was like, bro, this is fucking good shit.
Huge.
This is just helping me out. And this is just an example of how, you know, some people need it really, really badly.
Yeah.
And we just don't have a government that's currently in place, which is allowing us to progress. We're always fucking 10 years behind America.
Yeah. So exactly.
That's like with almost everything, but it's just important for us to just at least talk a little bit more about
it. So you're trying to like, so what does it run now? Give us a little, I guess, a synopsis of it is of like, what BestBudz is right now and how you're helping right now.
Yeah, so we're a marketplace for just CBD and hemp products.
Yes, sir.
But bro, we wanted to make sure that everything was like legally compliant because we knew that this could get sticky if we went too fast.
Oh yeah, and
if you don't think things through,
yeah, for sure,
then you're gonna get fucking destroyed.
Yeah.
One of the good things about corporate, bro. One of the good things, you just fucking overanalyze like those tiny little details.
100%
for opening up the business.
But
then I was just like, okay, I just identify how I can do this completely legally.
Yeah.
So then we spoke with a bunch of fucking lawyers, doctors, chemists, directors, bro. It was wild times, but I had to stop my 9-to-5 first to just cut that off. You know? To then be like, okay, I can actually just do this. Yeah, there was periods of time, bro, where it's just like, fuck, this feels like shit.
Yeah,
I don't feel like I'm getting anywhere right now.
Okay. But then
you have those moments where it's just like, oh, I'm on.
It picks
this
up.
This is life, bro.
This is a fucking game.
Straight in the matrix.
That literally feels exactly like that. Because so when you said I don't feel like I'm getting anywhere, is that what you mean? Like with this sort of creative journey? Sometimes like
exactly. This is like a platform where people can just access, like they can go through different types of, you know, products that are on the market.
Yeah.
But it's just specific to your own country.
Give us a few little examples. Oh, bingo bongo.
Bingo bongo.
One of them was
the G-Pen, bro. The G-Pen. So my mate at G-Pen, his name's Christian.
Okay.
He fucking sorted us out with this incredible like deal with like putting this out to influencers that are in Australia as well.
We're just
trying to get Australia just a little bit more high.
Yeah.
We just want them to be 100%. Like, okay, you know, start living it up.
A little.
Relax, bro.
Yeah, that's 100%. Take things
slowly, man. Just relax.
Yes,
people just want to rush.
And they think very far in the future, you know? And like, that's obviously, I love your passion.
Yeah.
I love your ambitions, you know? But just, you're stepping on all these things on the way, you know? Like, just take it easy, enjoy what's around you, you know? That's one thing that I really have enjoyed, like, since smoking up and, like, using just products in general. I just, like, life has just been, like, on the day-to-day.
Yeah.
It's hard to be upset, you know? Do you get me? Like, you see things and you evaluate things more. You take it for what it is versus like just like, oh man, that affected me, you know, I'm salty. Versus like, oh man, a bird shat on me.
Yeah.
That's kind of hilarious, motherfucker. Mm, like, after a while, do you get me? Like, there are small things. It's just like,
sometimes life shits on you, bro.
That's literally that. It's literally that. So you just got to, like, take it easy, take it slow. And that's exactly what CBD products do for you.
100% for 100%. And then soon we want to move to THC as well. Ooh. That's going to take some time, though.
Yeah, of course.
I mean,
you can already
get it legally if you go through, like, this specific process.
Sure.
But, fuck.
Yeah, it's a mission.
It's going to come soon, bro.
Oh, yeah, very soon. Oh, yeah, very, man, very soon. Keen. So
it's just a matter of patience.
Of course.
Yeah, it's good to be...
It's good to be in that fucking business. Yeah, of course.
Much more relaxed.
I mean, so you mentioned small things here and there, like that 9 to 5.
Mm.
How long were you in that 9 to 5? First of all, how long were you in that 9 to 5 grind? And like, what were you kind of doing, I guess? I don't really care where you were at.
Yeah.
Unless you want to say Big Four, baby.
Nah. I was in there for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to talk about it because it was like jail.
Yeah, fair.
But yeah, it was just, I feel like time just kind of like passed over.
Sure. At that point. Okay, it was
just glossed it over.
You just remember, just like things went.
And yeah, like, things just went. And then I was like, oh, fuck.
Same.
The moments where I was just like, living it up was when it was like with music.
Those
moments where it's just like, oh, I got the lens back on.
I got the glasses back on.
So it felt really good to be in those moments.
Damn,
but in there for 2 years and then traveled a little bit because I had the financial income to,
of course, to come because you're working that time, baby. That's the one thing you got to get. So that's what you got.
You got to get that cash first, and then you start understanding. It doesn't really mean that much.
Money doesn't really mean that much,
bro.
I see, I get you. You have to
You have to still understand that when you follow the path that you love, that's when it'll follow you.
Yeah.
That's when every good energy will just follow you.
Sometimes people have whack bars. Sometimes people don't come with energy or something, you know? Like maybe you're just like, man, do I regret bringing this motherfucker on even? Do you get me? Man, I'm just saying what they wanted to say. You know, that's all I'm saying. But like, is there ever a situation? Have you had a situation where
there's been situations where it's just been like, oh, like everyone's got those days where it's just like, you know, you have shitty bars.
100%.
That's fine.
100%.
That comes, but those moments go as the more you start writing.
Yeah.
But holy fuck, I remember this guy, you just kept on spitting bars, and it was horrendous. It was a violation, bro.
Like that.
Yeah, it was a bit too rapey.
Oh, okay. So like, yeah.
I was like, dude,
this guy's coming with crazy. Okay, yeah.
I don't fuck with this that much, bro. On your way, and then he just kept on going, bro. He just kept on going. I was like, okay.
Fair enough. He just kept on trying,
bro. He was just resilient. But I was like, okay, this has got to stop.
Yeah. Surely. So this guy got sent home. Oh, my goodness. Yeah,
he had to get sent home, bro.
He had to get sent home. Okay.
Bro, it was because the session times were from like 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. in the morning.
It was
like a one-hour slot. Sunday slot. So we had the Sunday sessions.
Yeah.
With the Homo Hype Bros.
Big ups.
So we were there at really like strange hours. So when you're hearing someone say that sort of shit at like 3:30 in the morning, you're like, bro.
Yikes, man. Yeah, exactly.
I don't know what's going on. I'm not having a good trip right now.
Exactly.
Not enjoyable, but definitely. I've had many retakes. Like, I've had to. There's this one track on the project called Cleopatra.
Mm. Yeah. Oh, bro. I was going to say I should really fuck with that. Yeah, go on.
So that had 29 different renditions. 29 different takes.
Wow. Okay.
There were some people that were part of the project as well. Mm. That I had to, like, there were some chicks that I had to cut off.
Okay, sure.
As part of the project, just because, it just wasn't working out. Like, the process and everything just didn't really make sense.
Okay,
have you ever had to, like, cut it off at any point?
I definitely know when a pod ain't going to be great, but so far, I guess I've been lucky, you know? Maybe I've, because, like, I definitely, look for guests that I want.
Yeah.
So I haven't asked someone that's like too cloudy. Like I haven't asked someone that's like too like, oh yeah, I need that person. Yeah, but like, no, I only ask people that I want. So,
absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, no, I don't know. So far, so good. I mean, I definitely have, no, I've had a fucking whack episode. But I guess maybe with musicians it's different because like sometimes maybe you have an idea of someone as a featuring.
Yeah.
And then they come in and they don't have that same energy or the same whatever. Is that kind of what happens more often than not? Or
yeah, pretty much, man. Like most of the times it's more so just you've got different musical concepts. Like you've got different types of ideas.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But the guys that I work with right now, it's incredible, man. It's incredible. Yeah. They're just like there's some type of synergy between teams. So everyone's got like different types of teams in there. In their life.
Yeah, definitely.
And this team is like family.
Huge.
So it's very important for me to also see them grow and watch myself grow at the same time.
Yeah, exactly.
So, you know, we used to fucking critique ourselves hard.
Yeah.
Hard. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Still do. We still critique ourselves very, very...
Like, yeah, of course.
Because like, at the end of the day, you want more quality.
Of course. Just putting stuff out. Yeah, of course.
It's very important that you... push your value.
Yeah, I'm all about that as well. It's all about like having a team that like the table, like everyone eats sort of thing. Do you get me? Like I want everyone to grow and get like better in their own right first. Do you get me? And then like best believe I'm gonna be your biggest supporter. And then it's the same. So it's like a vice versa sort of thing. It's just I don't know. I feel like
it's similar to how you would build your skit in the sense that you would be creating some like you're probably working on something. Big in the background right now, where it gets, it becomes the set.
It becomes the set features.
Like those are the pieces that you put your fucking heart and soul into.
Yeah. Where I'm just like, I think about it and I write it and I'm like, that ain't. Yeah. You know, and you just cut it back here and there. It's like very, like, the thing is like, it's always like about getting stuff out there as well. So like when I have a fucking team of like. Which I am working on as well. There are things that like, working on a team, working on a special, and it's just like, special, relax. Hey, yeah. Bill.
No, it is a special.
Yeah, exactly, that's what it is. Yeah, it is that. Yeah. It is a fucking special because it'll be the first special. And if I get like random 15s from around an open mic, no one can tell me.
Yep, 100%.
No one's going to be like, oh, you have to work for something. Anymore. Motherfucker, I've got a special. I'll watch that shit. If you don't laugh, then motherfucker, I'll move to the next comedy club.
Yeah.
And they're going to have me for a paid spot. And then it just goes like that. That's
the process, bro.
Yeah. So I'm working on that and like working on a team. Like, obviously I need someone that's working on cameras. I can't be doing both at the same time. But, and like, obviously everyone knows photographers and all that shit. But like, I know my boys that have started trying photography and I'd rather just help them instead. Yeah. Like I'd rather give them exposure and be like, you want to try recording a comedy special? I have no idea what that is either, but as in like, let's do it together sort of thing. And like there's a much nicer energy when you're like vulnerable to learn together. Do you get me? Like when you're like, all right, we'll grow together and like we obviously want this to go well. Like when, and like we care, it's like there's no money involved anywhere sort of thing. Yeah. There was never like a percentage talk or anything. It's just like if anything, I'm like, hey, yo, I've got the pod. Let me give you something. If anything, like, so it means more. Do you get me? But no, I get the synergy thing. Cause it's just 100%. Like, cause I remember my mate was just like, just get some eps out, cunt.
Get some eps, bro.
Yeah, he's just like, just get the eps out. And I was like, oh, I didn't know you cared like that. I was like, man, just get them out, cunt. And I was like, true. Just
give them goes, bro.
Every
single thing that you put out is just going to be,
there's just more out there. Yeah. It's part of the portfolio, baby. It's all out there. Yeah, facts, man. Oops. Oh, facts. Talk to me about Red Rum. Is that Red? Do we print?
Red Rum, yeah.
Or do we say murder? Or do we?
Red Rum.
There we go. Okay, there we go. I'm just making sure.
He's making sure.
I'm asking from the artist. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Talk to us about that. I listened through to it yesterday and today. Obviously, I need to give a few more listens.
Yeah.
That's not good enough.
No, that's all good, bro. Take your time.
But my best opinion, evaluation is I am very happy to give it a few more listens. Do you get me?
Thank you.
As an album as well, not just like the few songs. I do really like Cleopatra because someone went absolutely stupid on the sex, man. Someone went silly on that.
Bro.
Yeah.
Miles Davis style fucking.
My God, is this guy like 55 or something? Like,
bro, he's fucking 23.
Hey, props to you, man. I mean, obviously, I'm saying you killed some fucking... Cleopatra, you killed as well. I mean, like, you said 29 different versions?
29 different
Lyrics or, like, different, like, instrumentals? Or, like, what the hell?
The whole Logic file had 29 different renditions.
Yeah.
I had completed it, and then I was like, nah, this is not it. completed it again all the way through, like 29 times.
I've never gone to 29, but I know what you, I know exactly what you mean.
But I would always, I remember going back and forth many times.
100%.
Until I was just like, okay, this is the one that I'm going to put
through. It's fucking incredible music,
thank
by the
you.
Way.
But the whole project, it started off like 2017. It was 2017 when because I always used to just record on the piano or the keyboard and just have ideas in place.
Just have ideas in place.
I was like, okay, well, maybe I can use this sometime in the future as well.
Great way to think, fellas. Exactly. Invest in yourself.
Future proof, bro.
Yeah, exactly.
So I had everything there, and then I was building the project. I remember I'd toked up at a playground one night.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was having a really fucking bad trip.
Sure.
I was having a really bad trip.
Nighttime playground, some of the boys know it's a scary place. Not a good place.
One of the most frightening places.
For some weird fucking reason, bro.
Yeah, I think it's just because there's so many horror movies that we've watched.
Hollywood, from some.
It's like, oh, bro.
Nighttime at some playground. It always, But anyway, so
I remember that was off the same day that I had tried mushrooms for the first time. I tried in the morning, came back, toked it up, and I feel like it was
revitalized.
Like, oh no, this is gonna be bad.
Yeah,
and then I could literally feel like, oh fuck, I'm dying.
Sure.
I was like, oh, I'm dying right now.
Yeah.
Have you ever had that sort of experience?
It definitely feels like, oh, this is like, I don't know how it goes normal after this, you know. Yeah. Like, I can't see something without repercussions. I definitely have felt that feeling for sure. Oh my goodness,
it's crazy, bro.
Sometimes I'm like, am I stuck in this shit? But am I stuck?
But then you realize that, you know, you start, once you start coming off it, it's just like, okay, back to reality.
And you learn
so much shit from it, like
my goodness,
bad trips. And then I was like, okay, I'm gonna utilize this in my music creation. And I built that track Murder Interlude, which is all about like that playground environment and how it killed my ego and how it had like killed the fake ego.
Sure. Okay. Hey, we're making a. That's a screenshot right there. We'll put it in.
Ego and then fear. Yeah. So Franklin Ego was like in the, part of the project.
Mm-hmm.
Like when you hear it, it's just like, okay, there are two characters over here, but one doesn't make it.
Sure. Okay.
So that fake ego is eliminated.
Yeah.
And it happened because of a process of, you know, being with a girl, Cleopatra.
Oh my God. Okay. Yeah.
Cleopatra.
Yeah.
Her name was Billy Rose. Billy Rose meaning, you know, Billy.
Yeah.
And the Rose.
And oh my goodness. Okay.
And at the end, they had an L&B, a late night bomb.
Dude, that is, hey, that is quick with it as well. Hey.
Cheers, my dude.
Cheers.
Cheers, exactly.
I ran out, but absolutely.
So that was the entire process that I had for that project. And then I started moving on to, I had singles in place as well.
Sure.
But you get stuck sometimes, like when you're building a really big project, you kind of get used to the feeling of just building on it.
Okay.
Just letting it grow.
And then you kind of hold on to it.
But at some point it becomes a bit like an artistic burden where it's just like, okay, I just need to let this go so I don't have to just constantly work on it.
Sure. Oh, so, okay. You mean like keeping adding songs and like keeping adding details and everything? I see.
Songs, projects, everything. Like I keep on working on it,
then I will
just go down the rabbit hole.
Oh my God. So yeah, I never even thought about it like that. Yeah.
Yeah, so that's why what I try and do is I'll make sure that I... Wait, is this all good?
Yeah, I just made sure.
So I just wanted to make sure that, you know, I could at least create the flow that I wanted to at the end of the day.
Yeah, so definitely, yeah. And like some sort of... Do you have like... Is it like a feeling you want to portray, or like what is... Like definitely a story you want to portray. Yeah. Like you just did fucking quickly just then. Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah.
But the story itself, like I wanted... I didn't want people really to connect with it.
I need to. As much. Yeah, of course.
Understand. Like something like a journey that I've gone through.
Yeah.
And then I was like, okay, I'm just going to paint it for you.
Definitely.
Sonically.
Yeah.
So damn, I just wanted to try something that I've always admired. Because yeah. my favorite artists are people like MF Doom. I got Frank Jeez, Ocean.
Proper. Yeah,
Kid
yeah,
Cudi.
Yeah.
There's the list is going to go on. Pink Floyd. I will go
Yeah, yeah, crazy yeah. Proper. To, no, no, but no, like I
these,
you, yeah.
these people created massive projects.
Yeah.
Massive soundscapes where you're just like, bro, my...
Mind my actual, is melting. Yeah, like, yeah, 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 yeah. So actually, beautiful. Yeah, yeah, this is so amazing. Mind is melting is mind absolutely is correct.
What's who's your like favorite set of artists?
I mean, see, mine goes more down the rap hole, but like Flatbush Zombies changed my life in like
yeah, yeah.
when I was younger. So like, I
did
think,
you go to their concert?
I didn't actually. I was so fucking stupid, bro. I think I was overseas. Okay, that's why. Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, I remember that. I wouldn't give myself. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I remember that. I was overseas in Sri Lanka, but hey. Motherland, but
Lanka land, bro. Hey,
didn't want to be there at the time.
Yeah.
But dude, I need to see them in America. I just need to see them.
Yeah.
But they, yeah, I used to remember just thinking, because like, you know, we didn't like Cherrybrook and like, you know, you've got an amazing circle. I just remember back, I mean, I love my circles, but like in terms of the weed vibes. Yeah.
Weed vibes.
Everyone was like, man, why are you smoking like this, man? Like, why are you smoking all the time? And like, it was always very like bad connotations, all that kind of vibes. And I was like, man. And then like, Flatbush Zombies came into my life and I was like, dude, the music sounds better when I'm high. These cunts be putting out shit when they're high anyways. Like, it's like they've changed the high connotation for me, you know? And yeah. like, yeah, I think they've got a soft spot in my heart. But then like, yeah, Pink Floyd when I was on mushrooms that last time.
Oh, bro.
That, I don't know, what was the album called? I forgot the album name.
Like, for my birthday, they got me the vinyl.
Jeez,
they got me the fucking vinyl piece for the entire project. That incredible. Endless by Frank Ocean as well.
Yeah.
Just some crazy just things, absolute like those things when you just play them on the vinyl, you go into a different place. Yeah, just when you enter a different place.
It's yeah, honestly, when you give music that time and like credit, like it genuinely will change how it'll you think as well. It'll genuinely take you somewhere. So
that being
like,
said, like even some of the new music today, I still fuck with it, bro. Like I still think that, you know, if it makes you dance, it makes you move.
100%. Like, okay, exactly.
Like, complain about it. You can always pick up on trends and just be like, okay, it's been done before.
But I'm still gonna absolutely move my shit. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I get you. Why not? Red Rum, that shit, absolutely fucking. Now that you've told me that as well, I'm gonna re-listen and it'll be nice.
And this is the perfect weather for it, bro. This is the perfect weather. When it's raining, if it's raining, then you just just go into your car.
Yeah.
Chill out for a bit.
And then,
You don't have to drive. You don't have to drive. You can just chill out there.
Chill out. Oh, 100% actually. I can't drive, so I'll be downstairs.
Fair enough.
Fuck this guy. You said you got a bit of freestyle here today.
Oh, fucking oath. Yes. And I want you to be.
I've got a few lines. I think this guy, when he said he'd be a little late because he wrote stuff, I was like, shit. TWG in the kosh, baby. Remember that, yeah?
This is the TWG. This is the worst generation, TWG, where half of my peers donate to TSG. Buy vapes, get blazed under the green trees, French kissing in the dirty clubs, PSG. C'est la vie, fall into a pattern of depravity, rise really high but not because of gravity, no. It's just the rush of dopamine, mixed with the tingle that's brought to you by nicotine. Jesse, come on your episode, I'm a only fan. I put on a ring, now I'm a only man. Then I saw a big man, chuck a freestyle, Billy, where's the bully? Bring back Gorilla Sand. Please pack back the Billy as far as you can, so we can pack back through the cities in Afghanistan. Beautiful before the fucking plague of Americans. Use wordplay to say fuck Joe Biden.
Done with the
politics, back to the episode. It's just a bag of trips. A bag of trips. Put this on the Patreon. Here's the disclaimer for the sensitive ears. Close your IGTV for you listening to this. Fuck Kylie Jenner and half a family. Financial. Female insecurities, fuck cancel culture and the vultures that prey. They scavenge in the past and they dig for our mistakes. Fuck anyone that shuts down comedy. Why are you taking this shit so fucking seriously? Hey, last but not least, fuck Hollywood and Bollywood and any other kind of scheme that makes you suck a dick for scenes. It's trigger warning on these bars. Spray far from my mouth like a bleep it out. Bar so hard, they're on Viagra. Same time they bring peace. Call that shit Mahatma, entendre. Punctuated in my lungs. I'm punctured in my lungs, but I'm full of gas. My engine don't shut, my energy don't last. E equals MC squared, so to be fair, my energy is quantified by the strength of my peers.
Oh.
Dream team when it's me and anyone around. We need sleep cause we rise at 4 in the morning. Oh. While you snoring, I'll be working while you're snorting. I'll be sorting my priority to help all the homeless. Billy, I'll be honest, we're living in the worst generation, but it's not hopeless.
Okay.
We do the shit we love like it's oxytocin. When you do you and I do what I do, it may spark some inspiration for our peers and the youth. So I hope the worst generation bring a little clarity. Repent for the sins of our ancestry. Burn some trees if you're stressed, but don't depend on it. Stack your cheese to the moon, that's Wallace and Gromit. Love your family and friends. And let's just be honest, like what we're doing right now, we're still learning.
Right?
We're still learning, and this is going to take some time for us to still evolve. But I'm telling you right now, I know I fucked up many times there. I know I fucked up many times, but guess what? This is the process.
Oh my fucking days, Khan. How is he going to seamlessly come back into...
I'll be honest.
Is being honest?
Yeah, I'm being honest right now because in my brain right now, it's just dopamine that's rushing. And I'll tell you something crazy.
What are you going to tell me?
I'm telling you now, it's dopamine rushing, judging and loving. I think we're all addicted to scrolling and falling. Yeah, how many minutes does it take to get your pacifier out the pocket on a date with a fake smile and a lifestyle that complements your profile? Might want to dial down. I recommend exile like Julian, stayed snowed in, or cut it up like scissor hands. Mix the indica and get a happy ending. You get the message? Oops, I meant massage. This is no mirage. King of Genghis Khan, conquer till it's dawn. Wake up all like Braun. Braun King, not Saddam. Sodomy is off the table. That's haram. What's halal in this world that we live in? Yes. Sex is everywhere because we're walking in the city. Broke kings, so we live in thrifty. Break the family, history. Hope that we can make it past 50. It's a mystery. Biggie, when I'm with my queen, I'm always under pressure. I feel like I need to get another lover. Another
please.
Fucking lover.
1, 2, 3.
My Cleopatra, Hamidou name Medusa.
Hey!
My Cleopatra, Hamidou name Medusa.
Medusa.
Drop some bars for me, Billy.
Let me look.
Drop some bars for me, Billy.
All right.
Here we go, bro. Here we fucking go. Let's just start
man,
the podcast.
Man, woke up
from
today. One question. Is life exciting? Wait a minute.
Let's go, bro. Wait a minute. Run it back. Run it back.
Non-existent. That's it. Let me think. Woke up today. One question. Am I keep life exciting? Bro! What the? Hey,
bro,
dude. Should I start?
Bro,
I should have started before he started.
I think so.
I'm nervous after that, bro. That's...
You got bars, bro. Please freestyle for the people now. TWG, please freestyle. Give
2 seconds more. 2 seconds more.
You're hoping that money will break all your habits and pay off your debts. Only two things are certain. You can't run away from your tax or death. Hey, $50 million. Do you think that is enough to wash all your blood on your clothes, your hands, your soul? No, you're so fucked. Money won't give you freedom. Money won't treat you decent. Money's only gonna make your heart start freezing. Money's gonna leave you in pieces. Enemies creeping, collecting your scraps. Don't scratch back so they're asked for half. Work with some lads, emotions unattached. Tug of war with the demons. Only way you win is if you're scheming. Plan the game and take notes from the wise old man. Ilnam is the man and I'm trying to understand how I can break the fool and take all his bands. But it's easier than stealing candy from a young man. Step lightly on my 10 toes. Break the glass and free fall. Free from pain, end the game. What's the worth of one soul? Fight your foes for escape. No cut, no splits, no bet that contract's broke. Your democratic act won't work no more. If the chance comes up to get your life on track, don't act like you won't play the game no more. You sold your soul.
Sold your soul.
Play no more.
I just want to edit these goddamn clips no more.
Clips.
I lost my goddamn clips.
Clips.
I just want to rhyme with my chips. What the hell? He's them chips, apparently. Oh my god.
Chips.
Give me some. Dude, I had like rhyme little schemes, at least, you know? Where the fuck?
Everyone's got quality,
dude,
bro.
By the way, I'm going to actually enjoy editing that part. That's going to be...
Thank you, bro.
Lyrics are usually like... Not lyrics, subtitles. What the fuck? Yeah. But that's going to be enjoyable. Yes, wow. But my fucking guy, cunt. That was great, cunt. and very unexpected. I wasn't ready for an. To be fair, he actually does music, so as in, yeah. I don't know why I was expecting another Yoshi, but yeah. Oh my days, cunt! Literally, where's my? There we go. Give us a nice slow one, if anything. Yeah, it is a nice slow beat. You know, don't.
For a few beats. Beats by Dangy.
Yeah. Beats by Dangy. Oh, Beats by Dangy, shout him out. Beats by Dangy. There we go.
Dangy. Very,
is he part of the team? Part of your team?
He is the team, bro.
Oh, yes, sir. Huge. Oh, yeah. One pause while I get this up.
Yeah, yeah.
With the team, right? Sometimes yeah. I was always about, man, I can sing, not me, but like, say you can. I've already just fucking heard the guy can fucking rap like crazy. Can you play any instruments?
Yeah, I play the guitar and the piano.
God damn, you can play two instruments. Do you need anybody else in a music team, or can you explain some of the other roles? I feel like I don't really know.
Yeah.
Some of these other roles.
You need them.
You need them. You need a team, definitely.
Bro. Team is so crucial. You'll realize this as well once the team starts expanding.
Yeah.
Crazy, because everyone's got these really really interesting, you know, ideas that they have.
Of course, yeah. They want to
present, like, so, like you were talking about before with the sax.
Yeah,
Angus. Okay. Went fucking ham on the sax.
Okay. Yeah. He went crazy. Yeah. Very good.
Isaiah. He wrote the bars for Figo.
Nice. Yeah. Gave
me a lot of inspiration for my part as well. He came up with the idea of how about we have two different
egos. Yeah. Of course.
I'll be one alter ego. You be the other.
Yeah.
And then Dangy just helped out with the entire journey, as well as Mac Gambino
from
Killin' Studios.
Okay.
Absolutely incredible. Big ups, absolutely incredible.
That's mad. So what do? They just like actually put the music together, like producing it and everything. Yeah, is that what it is? Putting it together. Yeah. Interesting.
Stitch everything together, because everyone's got different material. Let's just stitch this shit together.
Yeah, and actually make the song itself.
Yeah.
Yes. Because
you can 100% do it yourself. Like, everyone can do it themselves.
Yeah. You're right.
But you should have individual projects, and then you should have like team projects as well.
Yeah, because you'll see a difference in quality. Doesn't have to be like good or bad, like six, but like you literally see like. Because people put, like, this Beats by Dangy, he's put his whole life's work into, you know,
100%.
His, like, producing or whatever.
Yeah.
And you've put your whole life's work into, you know, your singing and your fucking, not the whole life. Do you get me? But, like, your musical talent into these things. Why would you hinder yourself with that other process when you know, goddamn Beats by Dangy, he's got you, bro. Yeah. It's interesting. Like, I love that part of the team. Yeah.
Crazy, like, these paintings that he's got that he's not giving out.
Okay. Like, yeah. Oh. Like, hey, we're calling you, baby.
Incredible. Incredible. But yeah, so like you need the team to be there to essentially stick everything together.
Of course. Of course. Yeah. From an actual logistical point, and also just opinion as well. Yeah. That does help, definitely.
Absolutely.
I've got like small slow beat. It's not even written. I've just got a few rhymes together, hopefully.
Hopefully. I'm sampling it, bro.
I best believe me and Yoshi were there for an hour, okay? And we had like maybe like 10, 20 minutes worth of decent, like, okay, on the flow stuff. Rest we were sitting there like, bro, this is painful, bro. Yeah, like that's how you know musicians, like, that was actually good, bro. Cunt. Yeah. What the fuck? That was actually great. What did I say about the clips? Okay, yeah, I guess. Life's always been about these clips, man. It's just...
Keep going.
I've been having all this fun with all my friends, and like, then I have to clip it down for Instagram and TikTok. 1 minute.
Why is that?
Just a snippet, man.
Just a snippet? That ain't circumcision?
It's all... That's oh man, this life being just so just clickety, you know. Maybe I just want me a mini me. Man, get me a wife that can split the fee.
Fees.
Get a car that won't go rickety.
Rickety.
Man, got these deadlines, just need to spread them out. Big old full plate, need to eat them. Eat it out, yeah. Big old booty.
Big old booties. I had to eat them out.
Let me think.
He had to eat the booties out.
Fuck these callers, man. Fuck them out.
That's a no caller ID.
Oh.
Because they were not the VIP. But still, they were texting.
Yeah.
They hit that fucking hot bling.
Man, this guy the VIP. Don't be silly. Mm. This Neel B at TWG. Mm. He's having fun, I hope.
Yeah, I am, cause it's kinda fun. Yeah, ooh. We were getting dumb. Yeah, we were getting lifted. An hour ago, we just hit the swift, bitch. Yes, that's, you know what we're talking about. That green shit. It's not the lettuce, bitch. It's not the vitamins that you need. It's the fucking LSD.
It's the fucking LNB.
Mr. fucking Red Rum G. With the fucking B.E. Lee. And this fucking TWG. Smoke it like it's DSG.
Let's go.
Let's go higher to D. D.
Yes, sir. Very nice. My God. See, I used to think you were just a rapper, but then I listened to the actual project properly. Man's got a voice as well, kind man. Oh, beautiful. You just make music, you know?
Thank
it's just
very much.
Music that comes thank out of you your goddamn much. Body. That's just what happens, you know?
And I really want to, like, thank you for at least allowing me to put this bro. On your platform as well, bro. This is, like, honestly, I deeply respect that because I know that...
You understand you are exactly what this pod is about, you know? Like, as in, this motherfucker got skills from places he didn't want to be in. And then he's doing stuff that he wants to do, regardless of, you know, the little trials and tribulations. The fact that it ain't exactly 9 to 5, it might be even be 24/7, you know?
Yeah.
But the fact is, he wants to do it, you know? That's exactly what I want on TWG. Don't even fucking thank me, because you're going to come through next time as well, you know? First time and the last time is what I say. That's always. It. Definitely for this guy. I don't know. I told him I had a bad episode with someone else. You're definitely coming through again.
I appreciate
it. My goodness. Let me write next time as well. I didn't realize you could come with like sure. actual. Bro. Yeah, I know, bro. I underestimated.
Gorilla-san.
Oh, for sure. He is going to be intimidated after that. 100%. That's fun, bro. Dead ass. A half an hour session. You'll get like 5 minutes out of it. But it'll be great. It'll be great.
It'll be good, bro. Dude. You know what? This is like also great. Like, for me to put these ideas into like actual tracks as well.
100%, 100%, 100%.
I'm using this.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. Yes,
and
yes,
they're
yes.
be like, bro,
these guys had these episodes, too much fun.
Yeah, in these episodes, he's that shit, bro.
Yeah. Some sort of set. And like, I love the thing about samples in like music as well. Like, I smoked a cone, like, for, and then that ended up being in the intro of TWG. Do you get me? Like, these things
there
that
you
like.
Go. See, it's part, it just makes. It makes the whole thing.
Because it sounded nice, you know? Like, and then you like, it just sounded correct, you know?
It's what it needed. It represents
the
brand, bro.
Man, honestly, it's blessing to have Neel here today, man. Jet J. My God, no one's ever done it like that. Exactly. I don't even have to put the logo there. He's actually pointing at the logo.
That's amazing.
That's, man, my fucking guy. Literally, dude. Straight up, first time isn't the last time. Like, straight up. Genuinely, yeah. Everything's worked perfectly as well. Couldn't have, is that Billy? Couldn't have been Billy, bro. Fucking season 3 is different, kind of. Told you. But yeah, you haven't seen the first couple episodes just because I'm making sure consistency first, you know? Like, no point leaving you guys hanging. If I leave you hanging, let it be for a while and then I'll be back properly, you know? Like, I'll be back. But you know what? Thank you, TWG, once again. This has been Billy. This has been Neel B. Where can we have you got anything that right now that you want to show people or best buds? Talk your shit for a little bit, you know?
More
talk your shit.
More music to come. That's
beautiful,
for sure.
Beautiful.
More music.
Definitely more to come,
whether
please.
Whether you fuck with it or not, I couldn't really care less.
Because I'll be fucking with it, you know what I'm saying?
Be fucking
absolutely,
with it.
I'll be
and
there, yeah.
When me and Billy are fucking with it,
oh my goodness.
That's all that really matters, bro.
I mean, genuine. It'd be way more than just us two, but that's absolutely, I definitely get you. Yeah.
Nah, it's gonna be mad. So I've got a lot of projects that are gonna come out very, very soon. I've got BestBudz is obviously launching
huge
next week. So by the time that this is up,
if don't they, do that. Don't as in,
yeah,
yeah. As in,
no, no,
yeah,
no,
yeah,
not
maybe,
my,
maybe.
Even if they're seeing
it. Oh, jokes. Yeah, you will. Oh, it will be up. It
hey,
will be
live.
Up.
It's
oh,
right
there
now.
We go.
No,
that's
on the side,
very
side.
Good. Very
on
good.
Side.
Yeah, yeah. Guy, Neel B. This has been a fucking incredible episode. I love Tito. Sometimes when you get stuck in the pockets, you're like, is it worth doing all this shit?
Yeah.
Being a little corny bastard.
Yeah,
and then you do an episode and you're like, oh, motherfucker, I picked the right guest.
Yeah.
The guest is a motherfucking G. And it
nah,
just.
Bro, you're fucking good, bro.
Hey, don't worry about it. Hey, that's nice. That's very nice. But yeah, thank you so much, anyways. TWG, we'll catch you next time.
Later.
Yes,